Well, now to a disturbing story out of Melbourne and a warning. The pictures you're about to see are incredibly confronting. This is 61-year-old Patrick Reed, a tradie left bloodied and blue after a sickening assault in Notting Hill, hit multiple times with a brick and stabbed with a pair of scissors after trying to stop thieves from stealing his tools. He joins us now. Patrick, how are you going, big fella?
Good morning, Carl. I'm really well. Yourself?
Yeah, not too bad. I'm a little better than you, it seems.
I'll recover, but it's the dumbest thing I've ever done.
Well, let's talk through it. What happened?
Got woken up early, 5 o'clock. Noticed noise out the front of the property. Truck was parked, as you can see. Noticed one of the side wings was open on the driver's side. Went out to investigate. Saw a skinny gentleman in black. Next thing I know, I'm chasing him up the street. I caught him a couple of houses up, detained him. And while I was detaining him, he had some gentlemen come from behind and rearranged this beautiful face with some bricks. So no more modelling for me.
My friend, I actually think you're very handsome. But aside from all of that, this is incredibly, incredibly stressful. What a cowardly act. How would you describe these offenders?
Look, morning TV, I wouldn't like to say the words I'd really like to use. It's a fairly low act. The doctor said I was very lucky not to be severely hurt and or dead. I got some impact onto the side of my temple, orbital face. I'm still swelling up and bruising. I could have lost my family. My family could have lost me. It's a horrible, senseless, stupid thing that they've done, all for some tools. Yes, I shouldn't have gone out there. I recommend no one go out when this happens. Ring the police. They'll deal with it. That's what they're for.
But, Patrick, I mean, this is happening around the country, especially in Queensland at the moment. People have had enough. I mean, you say it's just tools, but they're your tools. You would have spent decades putting those tools together. Yeah. And it's yours. It's a piece of you.
Oh, yes. Oh, and that flashes through your mind as you go to do some form of vigilante justice, but where I'm at now, I can't work for, I'm probably out for a couple of weeks. I'm missing tools, and those that love me are really angry that I put myself in that position where I may not have been on the planet as we speak. So, you know, the doctors, the police, the nurses, everybody in the hospital, they were brilliant, but they did lay it down pretty heavily that I'm lucky to be here. And I just don't want anybody else, especially close to Christmas, to do and have to do the same thing.
I know, mate, but you're a man who just wanted to stand up for what's his. There's CCTV of cars leaving the area. The police would like some help in trying to track down those offenders. Can you describe some of the physical attributes of one of these offenders in particular?
Not a problem, Carl. Okay, so the young fella that was at the truck that I caught was skinny, probably about 23. He will be visibly shaken. He ran into a wall when I threw him into a brick wall. It's broken. He's going to be hurt. I'm worried about him. The two gentlemen that came from behind and beat me with bricks, they're 6'3", 20, 28, white, short beard. One of the fellow that was with the brick had a stubbly growth. He was a fat, out of shape person. Might be worth him going to the gym. But yeah, and the other gentleman that was dragging the other bloke away was little fat bugger too. So yeah, it's a bit hard to see with all the blood. So yeah.
Well, the cops are looking for two fat buggers. I bet you they hang out together.
At a donut shelf. Yeah.
You're a legend, mate. Hey, look, mate. I know when you make these decisions, whatever. But you should be proud of yourself, I reckon. And let's try and catch these fat buggers, and get them locked away. Appreciate you being on the show.
I just don't want anybody else to get hurt.
Yeah.
You're a legend, mate. Thanks for being with us, Sarah.
What an incredible person Patrick is.
Hey, thank you for your time today.
Oh,
isn't he beautiful?